Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about microcontroller boards and its applications. So it is the overview of this particular session. So the first one is microcontroller definition, and after that we are going to discuss about what are the popular microcontroller boards are available. Most popular microcontroller boards are Arduino Uno, Raspberry Pi 4, and Pigalle Bone Black Development Board, and Adafruit Flora Development Board, and MSP430 Launchpad. So these are the different types of the popular microcontroller boards are available. So we are going to discuss about what is meant by microcontroller. A microcontroller is a heart of an embedded system which is designed to perform a specific task by executing a fixed program in a row. So it is a low size, low power and low cost due to less number of external components. It is the block diagram of microcontroller. So it consists of ALU, register and timing controller. It is nothing but the microprocessor actually. So it also consists of RAM, ROM, timers, IO ports, serial ports, interrupt controller. All these are embedded in a single IC. So it is called the microcontroller. All these are embedded in a single IC. It in order to reduce the external components. It is used in embedded applications like washing machines, DVD players, ACs, etc. It is a heart of, simply remember, it is a heart of embedded system which is designed to perform a specific task. It is the main thing. So how microcontrollers are available? Microcontrollers are available in the form of a IC, and a dual inline package structure. It is called a DIP structure IC. All these components, timers, IO ports, serial ports, all these are embedded in a single integrated circuit like this. All these are the different types of the microcontrollers available. After that, what are the different types of microcontrollers? We have 8-bit microcontroller, 16-bit microcontroller, 32-bit microcontroller. It is a classification based on the bit. 8-bit microcontroller, 8051 is a 8-bit microcontroller, which is a very popular microcontroller. After that, 16-bit microcontroller, Intel 8096 is a 16-bit microcontroller, and 32-bit microcontroller. This type of microcontroller is generally used in automatically controlled appliances like automatic operational machines, medical appliances, etc. It is the classification based on the bits. So embedded system development. So for developing embedded system, we require two components. Those two components are the hardware and the software. Hardware includes the development board, and the software includes the IDE, Integrated Development Environment Software. These two are required for the embedded system development. These two are required for the embedded system development. So this development board is called the target system. So this software, IDE software, Integrated Development Environment, is called the host system. In Integrated Development Environment software, in this software, by using the editor, this IDE software consists of the editor. In this editor, we are just typing the program, we are just writing the program. After that, by using the USB cable, we have to dump that program into this hardware, into this development board. That means we are developing the code in the host system. After that, by using the USB cable, we are dumping that code into the target system. It is called, sometimes it is also called the host and target concept. So for embedded system development, we are requiring host system and target system. Host system is nothing but software, and target system is nothing but the hardware, which is nothing but a board. So what is a microcontroller board actually? It contains a microcontroller, memory and other necessary peripheral IO components. So it is a PCB, means so it is a simply printed circuit board. It is a printed circuit board containing all the components required for experimentation. Simply we can say microcontroller board. What are the popular microcontrollers are available in the market? The first one is Arduino Uno board. Arduino Uno board, it is a one of the popular board. It should be considered to be the one of the first microcontroller based development boards. Arduino Uno is the simplest and most powerful prototyping environment based on the Atmega microcontroller. So Atmega microcontroller is the part of the Arduino Uno. It consists of crystal oscillator. So it consists of the different analog pins and the different digital pins. It consists of 14 digital pins and 6 analog pins. It consists of 5 volts indication LED. Consists of USB port. How Arduino Uno get the power supply? By using the USB cable, you can get the power supply. It requires just 5 volts of power supply for operating Arduino Uno board. See here the pin configuration. See here the pins. 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11 pins provide the PWM output. See here these 6 pins are provide the PWM output. It consists of the 6 analog pins and 14 digital pins. 14 digital pins, it is the USB port, it is the reset button. By just pressing the reset button, we can change that or we can reprogram it. Okay. After that, it consists of 6 PWM outputs. And it consists of 4 SPI pins, which is useful for providing the SPI communication. So the serial communication is carried through these 2 pins. That is called the transmit pin and the receive pin. After that, pin 2 and 3. These 2 are useful for providing the external interrupts. So Arduino Uno is generally uses a basic version of the C++. So, what are the features of this Arduino board? I had already said it uses Atmega microcontroller. See the 8-bit, see the actually, see here it is a, actually 8-bit RISC microcontroller. Or 8-bit, it is the 8-bit. It is the 8-bit RISC microcontroller. It consists of 32 kilobytes of flash memory. Operating voltage is just 5 volts is necessary for operating this. This 5 volts is also supplied through USB cable. Input voltage is 7 to 12 volts and input voltage is 6 to 20 volts. So remember, it consists of 14 digital pins and 6 analog pins. What are these applications of Arduino Uno? Arduino Uno based RFID sensor device access and Arduino based underground cable fault detection and Arduino based home automation. This is generally used in the IoT applications. So it is a Arduino Uno. So what are the different types of the Arduino Unos? Arduino Nano. Arduino Nano, it also uses the Atmega microcontroller. Atmega microcontroller, so its operating voltage is just 5 volts. So see here analog pin for 8. So it consists of crystal oscillator that generates the frequency up to 16 MHz. Arduino Nano, these are the one type, and another type is Arduino Mega. Arduino Mega, it also uses the 5 volts voltage. It also works based upon the Atmega microcontroller. Atmega microcontroller, the PWM outputs generating pins are the 15. Consists of flash memory, 256 kilobits of flash memory. After that, it supports LED. It also supports LED. It is a reset button. It is Atmega microcontroller. So next type is Arduino Micro. It is the Arduino Micro board. So next one is Arduino Duo, and it is the red board Arduino board. These are the various types of the Arduino boards available. So after that, the second popular board is Raspberry Pi development board. It is the Raspberry Pi 4 development board. So they are having Raspberry Pi 3 and Raspberry Pi 0, etc. So it is a Raspberry Pi 4. So it was introduced, it is the latest board actually. It was introduced on the 24th June 2019. So it consists of mainly 1.5 GHz. It mainly consists of 1.5 GHz quad core processor. It is the brain of this device. So it is actually a 16-bit processor there. So it consists of HDMI ports, USB ports, etc. HDMI ports are generally employed for transmitting these are the HDMI ports. These two are the HDMI ports and These ports are actually employed for transmitting audio and video signals between the devices, and after that it consists of three USB ports, USB 2, USB 3 and USB C. So these USB ports, you can connect external peripheral devices like mic, webcams, keyboards for additional functionality by using these USB ports. So this module is available with variants of RAM including 1 GB, 2 GB, 4 GB, which can you select based on your requirement. So see here the pin configuration. So it consists of mainly 40 pins. These are the mainly GPIO pins are ranges from the these are the GPIO pins. General purpose input output pins are ranges from 2 to 27. So after that we are having SPA pin. SPA pin it is a SPA, I2C, UART, all these are for the serial communication protocols. I2C means inter-integrated circuit. SPA means serial peripheral interface, and UART, universal asynchronous receiver and a transmitter. So these are the all these are the serial communication protocols. I2C pins are the STL and SCL, serial data and serial clock. And SPA pins are MOSI, master out, slave, MISO, master in, slave out, and SCL, serial clock. So UART pins and transmit to the receiver. So remaining all these are the user power supply. Remaining all pins are the general purpose pins. So main thing Raspberry Pi 4 mainly consists of the 1.5 GHz quad core processor, which is of the 64 bit. Okay, let us see the various applications. So these are used in embedded system IoT projects. By using the Raspberry Pi board, we can develop a mini computer. Its size is just like a credit card. So it support all programming languages like HTML, Java. HTML stand for Hypertext Markup Language. In automation industries, it is used in making a portable gaming controller. Okay, it is used in the making a portable gaming consoles applications. So it can even handle the WordPress, so you can manage your own blogs and websites easily. So these are the various types of the applications included in the Raspberry Pi modem. So after that we are moving with the next popular board is the Pigalleborn Black Development Board. So it is the Pigalleborn Black Development Board. So the main thought of this Pigalleborn Black Development Board is also called the PBB. So 3 B's. So the main heart of this Pigalleborn Black Board development board is the ARM Cortex A8 processor. Okay, ARM Cortex processor will be the heart of this board, particular board. So it also consists of the reset button. By just pressing the reset button, we can clear the previous program and we can rewrite our own program. So it also consists of the USB port. So it is a micro SD card. These are the various types of the onboard LEDs available. So by using this port, we can supply the DC power. So these are the various types of the pins available in the Pigalleborn Black Board Development Board. So after that, it is one of the popular open source computer. Booting time to install Linux takes just 10 seconds and get started on development in less than 5 minutes with just a single USB cable. So the processor will be the ARM Cortex A8 processor. So it consists of 512 RAM, 512 megabytes of the RAM and 2 GB onboard flash storage. It also consists of neon floating point oscillator or so after that it will consist of the 232-bit microcontrollers and 3D graphics accelerator. It consists of neon floating point accelerator. So Adafruit Flora development board. So it is the Adafruit Flora development board. So it is just like a Arduino board. It also uses the Atmega processor. What is the processor which are using in the Arduino board? So see here, the main aim of this Adafruit Flora development board is to develop the wearable electronic appliances. So I had already said it also uses the Atmega microcontroller processor. So it also, the simulation is based by using the Arduino IDE. What is the software that is used for simulation of the Arduino? That same software will be used in the Adafruit Flora development code. It is very easy to detect the EMF signals to save ourselves from radiation. Wearable thermometer, for example, wearable thermometer, which is a very essential to the patients. Okay, it is just similar to Arduino Uno board. So what is the processor or what is the controller we are using in the Arduino Uno? The same controller we are using in this particular board also. So after that, MSP430, MSP stands for the mixed signal processor. It mainly consists of the 20 pins. It is a reset button. It is a reset button. So these are the LEDs and the jumper. So it is a reset button. It is the V1.3 button. It is the reset button. So these are the power connectors. It consists of the 20 pins mainly. It is a USB connection. So by using this port, we can connect the USB cable. So see here the pin diagram of the MSP430 microcontroller. MSP430. It is also called the MSP430 launchpad, or sometimes we can also call it the lunchbox. It was actually developed by the Textos Instruments. This particular instruments was developed by the Textos Instruments. See here this Begley backboard. This Begley bone black development board is also developed by the Textos Instruments. So this MSP430 lunchbox or launchpad is also developed by the Textos Instruments. So it mainly consists of the 20 pins. So it is useful for the test pattern generation. So VCC means we are giving the power supply, that is 1.8 volts minimum. So it is VSS is the ground. Xin means the crystal oscillator input. Xout means crystal oscillator output. So NMI, non-maskable interrupt. So it is a non-maskable interrupt. So what is an interrupt? Interrupt is an event which calls a normal program execution. Okay. So remaining 14 pins, remaining all these 14 pins are the general purpose input output pins, that means GPIO pins. So these four, this test pin, this VCC pin, this VSS pin, so crystal oscillator input pin, crystal oscillator output pin, and a non-maskable interrupt pin. Except these pins and remaining all the pins are the GPIO pins. So MSP430 is a, it has a 16-bit RISC-based processor architecture. What is the RISC means? Reduced instruction set computer. It supports reduced instructions. It supports less instructions. So it supports different low power modes. It is the main advantage of choosing this MSP430 microcontroller board. It has 16 registers, ranges from R0 to R15. So all the 16 registers are 16 bit wide. They have 16 bit address bus and 16 bit data bus. So after that, it is the specifications, or here are the features of this MSP430. So it consists of the GPIO pins. Minimum GPIO pins are the 14 to 80 pins. So the RAM is 128 bytes to 8 kilobytes. And flash memory size is 1 kilobyte to 60 kilobytes. So let us see the operating voltages ranges from 1.8 to 3.6 volts. So active operation will be the 160 to 250 microamps. So these are the different types of the analog and digital peripherals embedded in this this particular MSP430 microcontroller are the basic clock system, IO ports, serial ports, and timers. So watchdog timer. So watchdog timer, it is used to restart the microcontroller whenever a software or hardware failure occurs. RTC, real time clock, it will just provides the clock and date, and we are using the multiplier, so DMA, and after that we are using the LCD drivers, supply voltage supervisor, Brownette production circuit, emulator and JTAG interface, op-amp, comparator, and digital to analog converter, analog to digital converter, temperature sensor. All these are the different types of the analog and digital peripherals used in the MSP430 microcontroller. Okay. So after that, we are having different types of the applications of the mixed signal processor 430 launchpad. So those applications are the low power handheld smart devices. The main advantage of using this MSP430 is that it supports low power modes. Why? Because we are using the reduced instructions. So these are used in the test and measurement equipment, smart energy and smart grid solutions, factory automation, home and commercial site monitoring and control, medical instrumentation, fire and security, intelligent lighting system, transportation, motion control, automobiles, gaming equipment. For all these purposes, we are using the MSP430 microcontroller board. So, these are the various popular microcontroller boards available. Thank you.